Hello, my name is Joshua Nesbitt, a student at Full Sail University taking the online digital cinematography program. I was born on October 25th, 1985 in New York City. For my final project in this class, I'm going to be talking about Shakespearean movies, how it evolved over time, and the impact it has on the medium. William Shakespeare, who is often called the English national poet, and is widely considered the greatest dramatist of all time. The only proof of his existence is his plays, poems, sonnets, as well as church and court records. By 1597, William Shakespeare had already published 15 of his 37 famous and renowned plays. In the year 1899, the first Shakespeare movie was made, a silent film based on his play King John. In this brief clip, it shows the actor Sir Herbert Beerholm portraying King John, squirming uncomfortably on his throne. After that, another silent movie based on the play The Tempest came about in 1908. Directed by Percy Stow, it is about King Alonso with his entourage being stranded on an island, inhabited by a magician named Prospero, his daughter Miranda, and a deformed half-human being named Caliban. Shakespeare must be secured in the marketplace in order to survive in not only pop culture, but in all cultural forms. It led to the recognition of Hollywood film and beyond. Warner Brothers released A Midsummer Night Dream, paving the way for MGM's Romeo and Juliet in 1936, Orson Welles' Macbeth, and Julius Caesar. After 1989, film Shakespeare adaptations are focused solely on making Shakespeare's language more readily comprehensible and entertaining in order to guarantee the audience access to his genius. Director Kenneth Branagh did just that when he made a trio of British/American adaptations of Shakespeare's plays. Then Hollywood wanted to take Shakespeare adaptations in a brand new direction to appeal to a wider audience. Thus came the Shakespeare teen movies. It started with Baz Luhrmann's Romeo and Juliet, casting young actors and actresses and putting the story in more modern times. That became a trend for many years with follow-ups like 10 Things I Hate About You and Oh. Present-day Shakespeare movies further proves that his works transcends time and holds meaning in the ever-changing world we live in. Coriolanus is a prime example of that. You can also find remnants of Shakespeare's work almost everywhere. Adaptations from novels to movies was first done on Shakespeare's works and helped us give present-day adaptations we know and love.